Hello, I'm Joe LaVorgna. I'm Chief U.S. Economist for Deutsche Bank Securities in New York City. Since our last discussion, last quarter, we're talking a lot about monetary policy. What does the Fed do? What is Janet Yellen thinking? Will she be dovish? Will the Fed raise rates this summer? What will happen to the dollar? What's going on with China? Will that impact the U.S. economy? How strong is the U.S. economy likely to be? What data should we be following? All things that certainly are keeping people very active in the markets and likely will so for the rest of this year. The market should focus a lot on these purchasing manager indices. They measure activity within the factory sector, which has been very weak. That, we believe, is consistent with what should be a very soft quarter for real GDP growth. Some of the key indicators for the first quarter should show a much weaker growth profile. In particular, we saw the manufacturing ISM survey remain steadily below 50. That's typically a sign that the economy is quite fragile. There has been no material change in our forecast for growth this year. We expect the economy to expand at barely a 1% plus pace. Indicators we've seen recently, from durable goods orders to retail sales to industrial production to employment, all portray an economy that is very fragile. What we've seen over the past couple of months is a very large increase in inventory positions relative to sales. In other words, the level of inventories across the broad economy is now the highest since it was during the recession. In the past, when inventory levels are that high, firms need to work those inventories off. And when they do so, they typically reduce production and sometimes they cut employment. So the inventory situation is something we're watching, and we're worried that that could weigh on the economic data, at least for the near term, in the U.S. One of the key metrics we look at are employee tax withholding receipts, because we know that households do not pay tax on phantom income. And what we've seen over the past few months is a noticeable deceleration in the amount of revenues the Treasury has collected from various individuals and households. And what that tells us is that the income growth is slowing and that consumer spending may slow as well. It portrays an economy that's doing okay, but certainly does not appear to be accelerating at any fast pace. Meantime, we don't believe the manufacturing sector has yet turned the corner, because the U.S. dollar has increased tremendously over the past 18 months. We still believe that the contraction of the stronger dollar is yet to fully play out in the U.S. economy. At the same time, we know a lot of overseas economies, in particular in Asia, have been weaker than what many analysts have thought. So I don't believe the manufacturing sector is quite out of the woods. Fed Chair Yellen was very dovish recently, meaning that she does not show any proclivity to want to raise interest rates anytime soon. And to me, that really reflects what she perceives to be a much more fragile global growth backdrop, mainly that she's concerned about growth in Asia. She's concerned about growth in Europe. She's certainly concerned about growth in South America. If the Fed were hawkish or was to raise rates, that potentially could cause the dollar to accelerate or strengthen further. That in turn could weigh back on the U.S. economy. So the Fed chair is much more sensitive than maybe in the past regarding these global developments. My expectations are that the Fed will stay on hold through most of this year, and if we're lucky and the economy improves late in the year, the Fed will raise rates in December, but the Fed should keep rates very low for the foreseeable future. I'm looking for the remaining months of 2016 to be a more transitional period where the economy is expanding, but not at a very fast pace, something maybe only modestly above 1%. So it's certainly not a recession, but it's also not a boom either. And my hope is that with the right policies in place, regardless of who's ever in office next January, this business cycle can continue with the support of the Federal Reserve, and that greener pastures are still lie ahead.